So I would like to take the opportunity today of saying that if we in this country want to see effective change, then women have to be a part of that very important change. I think women have to make that change happen. You know that today in this country we are grappling with huge challenges. On one hand, we are facing these challenges of poverty, nutrition, healthcare, education. That's at a very macro level. But then when you look at it on a very different level, we are dealing with very ugly aspects of society, which is about corruption, which is about injustice, which is about lawlessness. And if we want to see our society change, and if we really want to see effective change happening, then women also have to engage with these issues. You cannot be a bystander. You cannot say that, oh, we are the wronged, we are the victims, and we are helpless. You cannot say that. You have to be a part of that engagement and bring about that change. So this is what we are really, really addressing today as educated women. Women can make a difference. Women must engage at the economic level, at the political level, and of course at the social level, which we are very engaged with. So today, I'm really pleased that we have someone who's actually engaging with the political system to bring about change, to make a difference, to see how we can bring in better governance, better political engagement and better politics. I think that's what it's all about. How do we make politics better? How do we make sure that politicians bring in better governance? And most importantly, how do women engage with this process? And that's why today on Women's Day, as we celebrate the advancements in the role of women in society, I would like to use this opportunity now to welcome someone who is really trying to engage at a political level to make a difference, to make sure that women get heard and that women become important stakeholders of the political system of this country, so that we can, as equal partners, bring about meaningful change. Because it's about changing societal mindset. It is about changing society. It's about changing the governance system. And it is about building an equitable and inclusive society where women have to be included. You know, we keep talking about inclusive economic development and all we think about are poor people. But I think inclusive economic development is also about including women in this development process. So without further delay, I'd like to basically welcome on stage Dr. Meenakshi Bharat. And I'm really pleased that she is now going to be standing for the upcoming MLA elections in the state, in Bangalore. And certainly she's standing from the constituency, which is the Malleshwaram constituency. I think I have been emailing my colleagues about your very effective campaign. I would like Meenakshi to tell you all about her party, about what she stands for, about her own background, because I don't want to sit and introduce Meenakshi and just rattle off her CV, because that's boring. I want all of you to hear it from Meenakshi herself. What was her background, why she got into politics, why Lok Satta, which is the party that is backing her, is an important party with a difference. And finally, I think I want her to leave it to all of you, and those of you who are in her constituency, to see if you can support her, because I think this is very important. This is not me making a political pitch, but this is giving Meenakshi an opportunity to share her thoughts. Of course, the rest is up to you, but I just think that on Women's Day, it is very important for me to bring somebody like Meenakshi to share her thoughts as a woman who wants to enter politics, and a woman who thinks that women can make a difference in politics. Meenakshi, welcome.